Courtauld of Italy, Italy of the 17th and 18th. The gondoliers in Venice, singing night and day, the opera houses in Naples, filled, bursting with over-enthusiastic audiences coming to liberate Scotland. And there in Rome, the priests dashing across the square in order to get to the Papal Palace to hear the latest opera in the same place. The student orchestras in Rome were so large. They thought the Greek tragedy was music, drama, art, all the arts came together in one art form. And Trinci recreated that with started writing music that enabled the words to be very audible, but weren't too many ornaments on the book that no one could hear what was happening. What was the result of the good goal was often was definitely not a part of the land, had it not been Claudio Monteverdi. Monteverdi was writing magical, which was very appealing and very dramatic, and he brought his idea into the monodic style that had come before that. He wrote a large number of operas, many of which were destroyed in a fire in the Italian opera house. We only have two provided in the four. One of the pieces you're going to hear is the Lament in the opera Ariana. That's the only surviving piece from this opera. And in it, Ariana says that she will be a martyr for love, a story of Machinaro. Then we have the love trip and the coronation of the pair, one of the surviving authors. It's a fascinating story, but one that's based on truth. It's based on Nero, the pair of the pair. Well, it was not the marriage of Octavia, but then it's Constantine, Octavia came on the scene. She was very good and skilled to love. She was never loving. And she calls me, and she wants to be queen. was originally employed by the King of Portugal as court conductor and as tutor to the rather gorgeous Maria Barbara, who spoke of uncomfortable and rather demanding of the students, scholastians at price of 500 monarchs. His dexterity on the keyboard attracted her to be the future King of Spain, and they were talking about it, and she went in over to Spain and took up a relationship with her. Scholastia often wrote a lot of pieces for her. She particularly enjoyed her hand drum. Apparently she grew rather popular for the age, and it became increasingly difficult and more entertaining. In his travels, Scholastia picked up influences from Italian opera, Italian keyboard writing, and Spanish and Portuguese folk music. In this speech, you're going to hear a very pastoral, lilting theme, which then turns into a little bit more.